If I have two qubits, A and B, and I would know they're in some pure state, psi A and psi B, then we know how to compute the joint state of the two qubits using the tensor product. If you're unsure about this, check out week 0. Now we want to do the same using density matrices. If I have two qubits A and B, and I know the density matrix of qubit A, and I know the density matrix of qubit B, how can I write down the overall density matrix of qubits A and B together? Of course, we would expect that if these were really pure states, then the density matrix of A and B should also follow our usual procedure. We could first compute the state of A and B, and our density matrix should be constructible from this vector. It is thus intuitive that for density matrix, we will do quite a similar procedure than we did for these vectors. And indeed, the tensor product can also be defined for matrices. In fact, it is done in an analogous way as it is defined for vectors. I will write it here for a qubit, but in the lecture notes you can find a general definition. The density matrix of A and B together is given by the density matrix of A tensor the density matrix of B, where the tensor product can again be expressed as follows. What I do here is I first write out the density matrix of row A tensor row B. And what we do is that we take the density matrix of B and we'll tack it onto the all of the coefficients of A. So what this looks like is like this. So I've tacked on rho to all of the coefficients. Let me now just spell out what this means like in terms of the matrix rho B. So if I insert rho B here, what we get is a big matrix rho AB. This is how we combine two density matrices for A and B into a big density matrix for A and B together. Just like for the tensor product for vectors, the tensor product of matrices satisfies nice properties. Namely, it's distributive and it's associative. And you can find this explained in detail in the lecture notes. To understand this tensor product of density matrices, let's now consider a simple example. The density matrix of A is just the zero state, which, as we've computed before, as a matrix looks like 1, 0, 0, 0. And the density matrix for 1, which we've computed also before, is 0, 0, 0, 1. So if I now want to compute the density matrix of row AB together, both qubits, I take row A and I tensor it with row B. And we'll now apply the rule of taking row B and tacking it onto the coefficients of row A. So what this means is that I have 1 times rho B, 0 times rho B, 0 times rho B, and 0 times rho B. So if I insert now the matrix rho B, what we'll get So up here in this corner, I just have this matrix, rho b. And for all the other components, I get 0. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and also down here. Note that in our example, row A and row B were pure states. So what we've just done here should be consistent with first computing the overall pure state by taking the tensor product of vectors and then turning it into a density matrix. So this here was just 0, 1, an element of the standard basis. So if I turn this into a density matrix, I have 0, 1, 0, 1. And if I write this out as a vector, this gives me 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, which gives us precisely the same matrix that we've just constructed. This is a simple example of how we can combine two density matrices, and we see that it agrees with the definition of the tensor product that we had made for vectors.